During the last week in Iceland, there has been an increasing level of concern regarding one of the nation's volcanoes. I am not referring to the Reykjanes volcano, which erupted twice in the last 2 months and is likely to erupt again within a month, nor am I referring to the Fagradalsfjöll volcano, which erupted for a time during 3 consecutive years. Instead, I am referring to the closest single volcano to the capital, Reykjavik, the difficult-to-pronounce volcanic system known as Brennisteinsfjöll. During the last week, a series of unusual earthquake swarms struck this very complex, potentially indicating the movement of magma. So, what exactly is occurring at the Brennisteinsfjöll volcano, and how concerned should we be about its recent activity? After all, in 2700 BCE, this very volcano sent lava flows into where southeast Reykjavik is now built upon. For context, Iceland's Reykjanes Peninsula represents a divergent plate boundary where two tectonic plates are spreading apart. While this usually occurs at a fairly constant rate every 600 to 2500 years on average, the stress created by uneven movement of nearby sections of the two plates causes a rapid release in strain. This causes a rapid rifting or spreading phase on the peninsula, which lasts anywhere from a few decades to a few centuries. The rapid spreading subsequently provides a path of least resistance for magma to intrude into, and unusually hot material in the upper mantle from the Icelandic hotspot subsequently intrudes into it multiple times. As a result, there are irregular periods of heightened volcanic activity on the Reykjanes Peninsula which affect multiple volcanoes, and since January of 2020, the peninsula has been in such a period. However, these strong rifting phases seem to be concentrated around a central point and cause a decreasing amount of activity the further away from its source in the plate boundary you go. Well, on January 27th of 2024, at 6:54 a.m. local time, the influence of the strong rifting seemingly expanded slightly eastwards once again. At that time, an unusual earthquake swarm began at the Brennisteinsfjöll volcano, indicating what may very well represent the beginning of its eventual reactivation. These quakes were centered in the middle of the Hussfjall-Bruni lava field and involved 16 earthquakes, some of which were felt in the capital, including a magnitude 3.2. These quakes were suspicious as they did not wane at the rate expected after a main shock quake, and instead have remained very constant ever since. My interpretation of this earthquake swarm is that it represents strain placed on the crust being slowly released due to the pooling or buildup of magma in either the upper mantle, moho layer, or lowermost crust at around 15 kilometers depth. I was unable to find any signs of ground deformation, so I can somewhat confidently say that a magmatic intrusion is not currently ongoing at Brennisteinsfjöll. However, this may change in the future as suggested by looking at other volcanoes on the peninsula affected by the strong rifting phase. Volcanoes on the Reykjanes Peninsula do not seem to immediately jump from 0 to 100 in intensity overnight, but rather take several months to years to fully come alive. I have made this helpful chart to help everyone understand the current phase each volcano is at. Whereas in January of 2020, Brennisteinsfjöll would rate on the scale as a 0, by 2 years later it began to produce a very negligible but sustained long-term increase in the level of earthquakes, bringing it to a 1. And now, 2 years later, once again, its first true earthquake swarm has occurred, bringing it from a 1 to a 2. People who live and work in Reykjavik and other nearby cities do not need to yet deeply worry about this volcano, but, in my opinion, should not build new structures in low-lying areas where lava would likely flow if Brennisteinsfjöll did end up erupting within the next several decades. An eventual volcanic eruption is far from certain, but now seems theoretically possible in the long term. As a result, scientists will now be keeping a close eye on Brennisteinsfjöll, although they are less worried about its current activity than they are with the two volcanoes which have already erupted multiple times since 2020. As a final note, I would like to thank this channel's patrons on Patreon and channel members on YouTube.